Can you make concrete without mixing? Like adding water, mixing up all the ingredients. Can you make concrete without that? Well, that's exactly what dry pour concrete's all about. And what do I think of dry pour concrete? I think it's got its place. And what are you gonna think about it? I think it's all about how do you like to make your brownies? And I'll explain that more later. My name is Tyler Lay. I'm a concrete freak. Thank you so much for watching this video, and make sure like, subscribe, and leave me a comment, especially if you've got some cool stuff you want me to do in the future about dry pour concrete. Now, do you need a small concrete slab somewhere in your life, right? Maybe to put your air conditioning units on, or your trash cans, or just outside your door? Well, why not try dry pour concrete? And this was popularized, not invented, popularized by this group called Cajun Country Living. They've got their YouTube video, they're fun, they're cool, and I'm linking to them above so you can check them out. They say this: you make your forms, then you take dry bags of concrete, pre-mixed material together, and you dump it into the forms. Yeah, dry, dump it into the forms. Then you smooth it out. What am I talking about? Well, that is the dumped concrete mix over there. That is a 2x4 that they use to strike off the concrete. And ooh, look at that smooth concrete mix over there. Pretty cool, right? Yeah, but you can do more to it. You can edge it. You can add some kind of texture to it if you want to. And after that, then you mist it and you wait an hour. And then they cured it as all good concrete people would, but they said it's to keep the chickens off. Yeah, watch out for those chickens. Then you mist it again after waiting, and you wait another hour, and you soak the slab then, but be careful to not disturb the surface. Don't just hit it hard. Just get some water. Keep soaking the surface again. Then you wait an hour, and you soak it, and you repeat this 3 times. And then, of course, you cure everything at the end, and you want to leave the forms on for about 48 hours to 72 hours, depending on what you want to do, because this stuff takes a little bit longer to gain strength. Now, dry pour concrete, in summary, is done like this. You place your forms. You dump your dry concrete into the forms. You strike it off, smooth it out. You finish it, make it look as beautiful or whatever you want it to look like. You mist it a couple times. You add water to it a couple times. Then you cure it, and then you're done. Let's talk a little bit more about that misting and adding water, because I was a little confused at first, and then I made a chart like this, because I'm kind of a graphical learner. And I said, well, at the beginning, if we have time here, when we mist it, we need to wait an hour, and then mist it again, and then wait an hour, then spray it, then wait an hour, then spray it, another hour and spray it, another hour and spray it. There's some sprays there and hours there, but you didn't have to mix anything, and it's not a lot of work to mist and spray. And I would cover the slab between mist and sprays because chickens, right? Yeah, and also curing and keeping that water inside of that concrete. So how does this work? What is this all about? Well, this is some of our dry concrete mix that are within the forms. If you go to mist it, then you see that water start to penetrate. That is now the wet concrete mix. And as it sits there, it will start to harden. That surface will start to get some strength to it. And so that when you mist it again, the water goes through and penetrates deeper. And then you wait a little bit longer, and then you pour a lot more water on top, and it penetrates deeper. And then you pour more water, and then it penetrates even deeper. Now, what are the advantages of this system, of this craziness of not mixing the concrete? Well, there's no mixing. Isn't that awesome? You don't have to have equipment. You don't have to have a lot of people. You can just put some bags and dump it inside the forms. And you avoid adding too much water. A lot of people add way too much water to their concrete. You're probably not gonna do that with this procedure, right? With dry mix concrete. And then little experience needed to do all this. And there are no time constraints at all on finishing. You can get that sucker looking exactly like you want. And it's easier to get it exactly what you want it to look like. Something like, if you want something like this, you may have to pay someone really skilled to get it. You can do it yourself with dry mix concrete. You can get dragon scales if you want on the surface of your concrete. That's pretty cool, right? And you will make concrete. It will be gray. It will be hard. And yeah, it's gonna be some concrete. So that's pretty cool, right? Now let's talk about the disadvantages, because there are disadvantages to this dry pour method. And you will not get the same performance as mixed concrete. You just won't. You may say, what? Why not? Well, dry mix will have more large air voids, big pockets of air inside. You're just not going to get them all out. That's why we usually do that with a vibrator that shakes the concrete and gets all those air bubbles out of the insides. You can't use admixtures. Admixtures are a game changer for concrete and make your concrete a lot cheaper, more durable, more sustainable, more just awesome. And one of the big ones is an air entraining admixture that actually helps stabilize these microscopic bubbles inside the concrete everywhere. And they are the key for freeze-thaw durability. I talk about that in this video here. Make sure you check it out. But your cement will not be well distributed. It's just going to be where it's going to be, probably clumping around rock and sand particles and not well distributed like you would get if you made a slurry and you mixed it up. And there's some questions here now. Does adding water to the surface, does that create microchannels on the surface? What am I talking about? Does that create like something like in the ocean, right? Where you see a lot of water coming through and you see those channels where the water starts to be. If those were there, does that hurt the quality of the surface, the durability of the surface, the abrasion resistance of the surface? I'm not sure. And will dry mix bond to rebar? I mean, rebar is another game changer for concrete. Do you get it to bond? Now, I know you can put rebar inside. I'm not saying that, but do you get the bond? Do you get the performance? Does it tighten and stop those cracks from forming, or at least getting large? And what does all of this have to do with brownies, right? I talked about that at the beginning. Well, have you ever bought a box brownie mix before? You know what I'm talking about, right? Like the brownie mix where you add water, an egg, and maybe some oil in the mix, and you get yourself some brownies. Was it the best brownies you've ever had in your life? Probably not. Was it fast? Was it simple? Yes. And you know what the best thing of all? You got brownies, right? And like Rachel Ray would say, yummo, baby. So this fudge box brownie mix is kind of like, it's like dry mix concrete. I mean, that's kind of what this stuff is. It's kind of like the box brownie mix of concrete has its place. So in summary, really, truly, honestly, dry pour has disadvantages, but it is a simple, easy way to make concrete. And you know what? I'm a fan of simple, and I'm a fan of easy, and I know there are the zealots, the people that are hardcore concrete people out there that say, that's not my concrete, I don't like that. And I get that. I get that, but you're kind of like being the Mandalorian, right? When he says, this is the way. I mean, aren't there other ways? But concrete can be overwhelming. I get it if you are a newbie to concrete, and I'll tell you, if this helps you, if this makes your life easier, if this gets you over the edge to do that concrete project, then by all means, that you should use it. So, but how can dry pour, I think, really be a game changer? I mean, a big time game changer. And I'm being serious here. I mean, if I had to make something like this, it's like beautiful, crazy sand art, but in concrete that lasts forever, I think dry pour concrete could be an amazing way to do it. Get it all carved in there and then add some water to it. I think it could be great. What if you wanted to add the opening scroll to Star Wars to your driveway so you could see it every single day? I think dry pour concrete could be an awesome, awesome way to make that happen. So in summary, I hope you like this video. I hope you will like, you will subscribe, you'll leave me a comment, especially about future tests you want me to do to dry pour concrete, because I'm looking to do some. My concrete freaks, check me out on the gram and the book. Take care, everybody. Peace.